What is up, TSFL Nation? I'm back with another reaction. And this is a subscriber's request. If there's any videos you guys want me to do, leave them in the comments. So, we're about to check this one out. Let's get right to it. What the heck? Is that a ball? Oh no.
Attempting to make it stop running. In some variations of the sport, they have to ride the bull until they can remove flags that are attached onto its horns. Now, in last year, 2016, the sport was actually banned because PETA India protested against it. So the Supreme Court of India was like, nah, can't have this no more because a lot of times people got injured and sometimes even died. Now, this resulted in a
shoot.
Protest by the
I wouldn't even do that. I wouldn't even try that if you paid me to. I wouldn't even go running with the bulls. That's how, like, nah. They're dangerous. They'll try to kill you. What the hell? But I doubt the bull is getting any pain.
Because if a bull isn't tamed, that means that they're very strong and healthy. So obviously when they're used in making offspring, their offspring are going to be a lot stronger and healthier than the ones that were tamed. These stronger and healthier bulls also sell for a higher price, and this makes the event even more valuable for farmers. Between the years 2010 and 2014, more than 1,100 people had gotten seriously injured because of this event.
Only 17.
However, banning the sport actually does endanger the livelihoods of traditional farmers. Basically, Locally, farmers don't really have any more incentive when it comes to breeding these bulls for the festivals now that it is banned. The livelihood of these farmers are already at risk because of the use of motor pumps, tractors, and other machines. Now, most recently, at the time of filming this video, over 20,000 students and other people conducted a rally at Chennai's Marina Beach on the 8th of January 2017 to urge the government to restore Jallikattu. So that wraps up this episode on Jallikattu, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you are from India or surrounding areas and you know of the sport, I'd love to hear your thoughts about it down below. Was there anything I missed in this episode? Feel free to share all your thoughts and comments down below in the comment section. Thank you guys for being so awesome. This topic was actually brought up to me by accident. Actually, myself and Dave went to like this YouTube event, and then I started talking to this security guard. Turns out he was from India, and he started watching STD Facts episodes just like right on the spot. And he was like, yo, you gotta do an episode on Jallikattu. I was like, what is that? So we did some research, and here we are. So yeah, we are still taking requests, of course. Anytime you have a request, let us know. Send it to our email, ftdfacts@gmail.com. Or you can just leave it down below with your other comments. Also, hit me up on Instagram, FTD Online. Link to that is always down below. Until next time.
All right, so this is a crazy sport. I wouldn't do this if you paid me to do it. I'm not messing with no bulls. I don't care. You can call me any names you want. Never messing with bulls, because they can kill you. I mean, some people don't realize that, and some people get like back problems or certain problems after that. I think somebody I knew went running with the bulls, and then their body got messed up after it. So hopefully when people do this, they're doing it safely. But thank you guys for watching. Like the video, like to subscribe if you're new. Yeah, guys, peace.